we existed before the 1960s. Like, Black Cowboys were around, yeah. and these stories that haven't been told, this character, Taylor wrote him, it's a strong, dignified, you know, to me, he's the humanity of the show. He's the soul of the show. And as it goes on, you see more of what I'm talking about.
Wait, man, first off, congratulations.
Thank you.
You know, I was talking to your guy, Sam Elliott.
Yeah.
And you should make him your agent. He is singing your praises about this young brother doing it and crushing it. For you, what does this experience mean to you to work alongside legends like Elliott and Billy Bob Thornton and Faith and Tim McGraw? I mean, yeah. everybody on this cast, you get a chance to be front and center and killing it.
Thinking about it, like, you know, when I got the job and they said who's going to be a part of it, and it was like, it kind of gets overwhelming. And you're like, you know, like, you know, athletes before the Super Bowl, like, it's just another game. Just not, if you make it bigger, then
keep
you,
it cool.
you know, yeah, keep it cool, just another game. So, and you're working, and then you find out Billy Bob's coming, then you find out Tom's, and there's other, you know, actors that haven't been announced that are coming, and it's, so for me to keep it all just in perspective, I just try to bring this character to life, and for me, Black Cowboys, underrepresented in this genre, we haven't, you know, stories haven't been told. So if I focus mainly on bringing Thomas to life, all the everything around me that's larger than life, it doesn't affect me because I'm focused on my you know what I'm trying to do.
Yeah, stay in the game.
Yeah.
And you touched on that, you know, talk to me. One of my main jobs, I have five young children, is to teach about Black history.
Yeah.
You know, for you, what does it mean as a young actor and artist to have the opportunity to bring the Black cowboy history and legacy to life on screen?
It means everything to me, and it's the same thing. Like, my son, like, I want him years from now to be like, my dad was Thomas on, you know, this show, and it's like, I never had that. I watched all the Westerns growing up, the Gunsmokes, the Bonanzas, the Wagon, and I, you know, my mom loves them. We sat there and watched, that was our family, what we did. And it, you know, just because that's what it was, you don't realize you never saw people like
us.
You never saw it, and it's just, it was what it was. And then you get older and you start realizing, like, we existed before the 1960s, like, Black cowboys were around, yeah. and these stories that haven't been told, this character, Taylor wrote him, it's a strong, dignified, you know, to me, he's the humanity of the show. He's the soul of the show. And as it goes on, you see more of what I'm talking about. But it's, he sees things very black and white, and that was important to me to have this pride and bring this honor for this character, for people that look like me and kids coming up that, you know,
yeah.
you know, we existed.
Being a role model for young, you know, black and brown kids everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a beautiful thing. When I was a kid watching the shows, I mean, John Shaft and, you know, Huggy Bear were, you know,
he was. Yeah.
But now,
that's what it was. And for me, I saw this a couple weeks ago in Amarillo. We saw the first two episodes. And I didn't want to see it. I didn't really want to, until we're finished with everything, I didn't want it to get in my head, you know, just whatever. The opening credits, seeing, you know, the picture with the name under it. But that hasn't happened for black actors. Otis Young was one of the first ones, you know, in The Outcast that had his name and his face
right.
with that. Then even Lonesome Dove, Danny Glover, they didn't have, you know, they had the name, but they didn't have the faces. Seeing that face in that tintype, the strong black cowboy was like, I just lost it. I cried from that moment on for the next 2 hours. And, you know, I was like, man, why'd y'all do that to me? I told you I didn't want to watch this show yet.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. Your gift, man. So thank you for that.
Yeah.
I'll make sure my children are going to see this. You know, talk about the challenges of doing something like this, because you guys are in it knee deep from, you know, physically, emotionally, mentally. This is not an easy shoot.
No.
What do you like most, and what are the biggest challenges bringing this to life and making it look real?
The challenges you're dealing with, first of all, you're going from place to place, harsh conditions. You know, 95% of what we do is outside. So if it's 100 degrees out, humid, you know, you're in Texas, Fort Worth, summertime, you're going through it. If you're in Montana and it's freezing, you're going through it. You're on a horse, your horse doesn't feel like doing what you say today. The cows don't feel like being herded today. Like, you just, all the elements around you are against you. So that's why shows like this haven't been done in a while, because it's extremely difficult to do, but as difficult as it is to do, it's beautiful to watch when it unfolds.
And
to me, it's rewarding. To me, the main character on this show is nature. Is the backdrops, the mountain caps, the Brazos River, like, you know, that's, And we're all a part of just filling in that world. And it's just, when you see that, when you hear horses come running up, like it just, it does something to you as an audience, like watching that. It just feels real and you just feel like a fly on the wall.
Coolest gig of your career so far?
Yeah, I have to say, and you know, it's like, I don't, who knows what's after this, but just, this is so significant. And us traveling around, like when you usually get a show, you're in a studio, you drive to work, you're in that studio,
and that's what
we're in Montana. We're going to different cities in Montana. We're going to different cities in Texas. We're bouncing around. You're with Sam Elliott. You're with Billy Bob Thornton. You're with Tom Hanks. You're with Tim and Faith, like Isabel, like it's Taylor. This is significant. This is, and the story that is being told through the lenses of, you know, different people that didn't have a voice, even the immigrants, their voice, like we haven't seen that from this time period. So it's significant what we're doing. Hopefully the perspectives are changed after people see this.